Hey, my friends, it's your friend Kevin. Welcome, welcome, welcome. This is your divine inspiration message for today. All right, so we are in a angel numerology number 7 today, which to me is we're in the right realm, we're on the right path, we're heading in the right direction. This is about spiritual desires and plans that are correct and beneficial, and setting our priorities in the right order for good life choices, particularly when it comes to material matters. Now, it does work with the Seven of Cups in Tarot, the Sun, the Chariot, also Archangel Metatron and Archangel Michael. So, it may seem that things are moving in a weird direction, and we may be faced with some choices, because to me, when I look at the Seven of Cups as a card, I get that sense that on the physical plane, we could be getting confused with what choice do we make, but we have to make a choice. That's where procrastination comes in. So what I'm here to tell you is go within, you won't go without, get meditative, get contemplative, and choose one thing, one priority, one choice, one path that you can take. And now we'll get on with our cards. The Happier Me affirmation card is, I am doing my best and that is enough. We can grow only by accepting our current limitations. Time will bring new skills, but also new limitations. And each time we will do our best with what we have. That is the attitude, the intention that we should go through life with. I am always doing my best, and my best will always be good enough. I think that that's, if we can get up in the morning and say, today I'm going to do my best, and my best is always going to be good enough, that's enough of a good attitude. So my isms, I am love, I am God, I am worthy, I am infinite, these are all true statements, they're all affirmations. If you were to dance a jig all day long and say that, you would be in the right direction. I am magnificent, and I magnificently manifest my future right now. Whatever you want to see happen tomorrow, next week, next month, Christmas, 2025, you've got to think of it, feel it, and make it happen. But do your best. This one I really like. Gratitude is the engine. Love is the fuel. If we're grateful for all that we have, if we're grateful for all of our, even our missteps, even the missteps that we set forward and said, well, I didn't really intend that to happen, but it happened. What can it teach me? What can I learn from it? How do I get past this feeling? Because, you know, I think feelings are like weather patterns. They just, like clouds, they just move on by. They just keep on going. And as we all know, as we tread through this pathway of life and light, things are coming at us. They always will. It is how we respond, not so much how we react, that too, but how we respond to them that truly makes a difference. We have the Divine Master Thoth with us this week, who's telling us we have to awaken the teacher within us and understand that whatever we've learned, whatever we've come to know, we now get to share it. I feel like, and I've always felt like, the student and the teacher are left hand, right hand, sock and shoe, salt and pepper. One has to have the other. I have to be a student before I can teach anybody. And I got to be a teacher in order to learn more. So I learn how my students respond to what I'm teaching. That's how I learn. I can't teach anybody unless I'm really tuned in to what and the way they learn. I hope that makes sense. I've asked my girls, although they don't have genders, my peeps, my fairies, Gertrude and Beatrice. This is a Bumblebee Jasper, in case you want to know. I love me a jump Bumblebee Jasper. Here, I got forgot what this is now, but I found it. It's for, it reminds me of Archangel Michael. Just saying. Here we go. So I was asking them this morning, where are you? And surprisingly enough, they were laying down in a field of poppies, right? So I was thinking, the only time I've ever seen poppies, that many, was on posters for remembrance, like military remembrance. Gertrude opened her eyes wide. She was picking them. Beatrice said, "We're here to remember all of those who walked the pathway before us, who have ascended into spirit. Gather them around and talk to them. They want to hear from you." And like, okay, well, that makes sense. It's very sacred. Poppies were also used in Greek mythology. Of course, you know, they use poppies to extract opium. It's known for peace, relaxation, hypnosis, all of the things that make us relax and go inward. And I think that may be what the message is, just to relax. Use this time of August, where the summer is not quite finished, the fall has not quite started, and the activities and the action of the summer are sort of slowing down a bit. Students are getting ready to go back to college and school. The business acumen of commerce are getting ready for like the last push of the year for their finances. I feel like I'm just blathering on here, not really making any sense. Right, give me a card, please. Give me a card, give me a card, give me a card. Here we go. Don't forget, tonight, 6:30 on Eastern, is my happy hour at the Woo Woo Lounge. We're going to be talking about growth. We're going to be talking about how we give up the commitment to it. What is it that we sabotage ourselves? And when is it that we've had to pick back up and go back to it? Oh, here we go. The colors of pink and the colors of violet. And look, we have our ballet dancer who is walking the tightrope in a gorgeous lavender dress. Like, look at this woman. She is saying, listen, I got all that I need and I'm handling it. Strength, balance, preparedness, tranquility. We've got the caduceus here on the bottom left, the stopwatch right above it, the dove, the heart, making an M. Look at that, Archangel Michael to me. On the other side, we have a half wing. We also have money. And we also have graduation, learning. The message is, use this time to balance out what brings you joy, what brings you happiness, what brings you fulfillment, where is your gratitude, where is your love, where is your time management, what are you putting off, what are you sharing, and all of these things. I'm going to put this up here on my little 8-pointed star here. There we go, along with Toph. I'm getting some messages from these two energies. You know, sometimes we've been in the throes of go, 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 and we've just had enough. Stuck. It isn't that we're stuck. You know, every so often I'm in the traffic and I get up behind a city bus and the city bus just stops, puts on its hazard lights, and sits there. They have a timetable. They've got to get to where they've got to get to at a time. And sometimes they have to make up that time. So, of course, traffic builds up behind the city bus, getting upset, getting angry. I want to move. I want to go. No, use these times of respite to make your affirmations, write them down. I have a whole list up here on my wall. I am loved. I am enough exactly as I am. I am doing my best and my best is good enough. I am worthy of my own love and respect. I am letting go of self-criticism. I am healed. I release myself to the divine. I am no longer fixing other people. I am safe. I am secure. I am self-confident. I am beautiful. I am magnificent. I am anchored to who I am. I am anchored to my truth. I am anchored to my love. You know, sometimes we have to do an internet search for things like calm, cool, collected. If you do that, you'll see where your hard work is paying off, where your perseverance is moving forward. Lots of times we face, you know, I do readings privately and publicly, and I've got the now the happy hour at the Woo Woo Lounge. And sometimes there's not a lot of information that comes through. And, you know, there was a time where I would be asking Spirit, well, what do I need to tell this person? What do I need to share? Because I always felt like the intention was to wow somebody, to bring them the miracles of the message. Oh, my goodness, you know. But sometimes there isn't. Sometimes all that Spirit wants us to do and be and experience right here, right now, are these things. Love, God, worthiness, infinite. There's no rush. I think that we have all been on this treadmill of go, 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 got to do it, got to do it, got to do it, and checking that list, that priority list. And sometimes I can get so ingrained in the way we are that to just go out there and do nothing, to just go out there and be peaceful, to just paint or draw, or in my case, I don't have it with me right now, get obsessed with yarn. Oh, gosh. It's I like it. I like it. It calms me down. Last night, I was watching comedy shows. If you are familiar with British comedy, there is a sitcom. You can look it up. Mrs. Brown's Boys. It's silly, ridiculous, but it's funny. And I just wanted to laugh out loud. I don't know why. Anyway, I was watching all of that while I am basically making a throw. I should remind myself to go, you know what, I'm going to go get it, because what I wanted to have happen didn't happen. I'll be right back. All right, so I promise it won't take long. If you're bored, you can switch it off. You know, I went to my store last week and I made this shawl, right? It was quite lovely. And while I'm in there, I find these cakes. Again, it's in the bargain bin. These two things, right? They're whatever this is called. I'm doing a commercial now. It's called Mandala Bonus Bundle. And the color, they're both the same color. What's the color of this thing? Because I always have to get, now I know I've got to get two. Right, so the color of this stuff is called, of all things, Gnome. G-N-O-M-E, Gnome, right? However, I was drawn to how these bright, vibrant colors are. I thought, gosh, that's lovely. I can go through all the chakra colors as I do it. Well, I started, and the woman I've been following, her name is, I don't know what her name is, but she runs a little channel called Pretty Peaceful out of Colorado. Anyway, she's saying that you have to join these two yarns together and work it as if it's one yarn. All right. So I started in the middle of those cakes. I found the centerpiece, I pulled one, and then I pulled the other. Well, they weren't matching colors. They didn't like line up. It wasn't like the purples were together and the blues were together and the greens were together. So I thought, well, they're not the right color, but for me to go and find the matching color, I'd have to pull an end from somewhere else. I didn't want to get tangled up. Well, this is what happened. I started, and we started with this green and this orange. And as we're going through the cake, it's changing to pink and yellow. And it goes on, it goes on, it goes on. Well, now I've got to this point where I don't know if this is pretty or ugly or what. But now I've got to where I'm doing this, they call this double crochet, but I'm doing this thing to make a throw. And I'm like, these are turning out to be university colors. Like, I had the colors of Clemson going on. I had some color. I'm thinking, I am not into sports. I'm not into football or any of that stuff. It's just quite delightful. Anyway, I kept going till I got my 100 and some odd stitches across, and now I'm at 20 rows up. Just saying. I think I'm turning into one of my ancestors. Thank you, thank you. I love you, I love you. My point being, with all of this to say, whether you paint, whether you draw, whether you get obsessed with yarn, whether you do meditation, whether you play an instrument, there is a piece of us that has to be balanced. We cannot all be work and worry, work and worry, work and worry, work and worry. We need strength, we need balance, and we need to be prepared for whatever's coming next. Know that you are doing your best all the time. And that, my dear friends, is quite enough. If you like this, share it. Get it out to as many people as you can. Don't forget to sign up for my happy hour at Woo Woo Land tonight, or Woo Woo Lounge. Go to my website, kevincross.com, head over to the events, and you'll find tonight's popping up there somewhere. I love you. Till tomorrow. Bye for now. Hey everybody, we hope you've enjoyed the video. If you did, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share it with all your friends. Here's a QR code if you decide you'd like to get a private personal reading with me. I'm available most evenings and on the weekends. Just go over to the website, book in what session, 30 minutes, 60 minutes, and then fill in the contact information, and I'll be back in touch. And if you feel kind enough, here is a link to my donation button. Energy exchange of any amount is always gratefully received. Until next time, be well, be blessed, and thanks so much for watching. Bye.